So today I am here. I'm going to head into my woods and we're going to hopefully be photographing deer, crows and all of the beautiful autumn colours. Alrighty guys, unfortunately it seems like the monk track has disappeared into the wilderness, but I wasn't expecting it to do anything else apart from that. They're very clever animals along with deer, and we only have one species of deer around our house, and that's roe deer. Recently I got a couple of pictures of those, and I've posted them on my Instagram, so the link will be in the description. But anyway, let's get back to photographing the autumn colours and wildlife. Okay, this is awesome. I found a cool shot which I can take, which is going to be of just this little trail where all of the deer, fox and badger use. So I'm going to set up my new tripod. I've got a Manfrotto now. It was given to me by my uncle, who was a semi-professional photographer, and I'm going to whack my Canon 1300D on it, and this is going to be the last video it comes up in, and also my 75-300mm lens, and we're going to take some landscapes of the forest. Alrighty, so the sun has just risen and it's done exactly what I wanted it to do. It's created this really nice warm light around all the trees, and just because the clouds are there, the light isn't too hard, and it's just a really, really nice light. So Max, I'm gonna either go down to the lakes over there or just photograph this path, and either way it's gonna be fantastic, so let's make the most of this awesome light. Alrighty, so this is the shot I'm taking. It's it's just there. Probably looks a bit overexposed to you. All these colours up here though are magnificent. They're all like really nice light greens and dark greens, and the contrast is really nice because the light isn't too harsh. So that is making the picture look really, really good. Alrighty guys, so I've got that shot now. I'm going to pack up my tripod and look for a new scenery to photograph. This next shot isn't a great composure. Well, it just isn't a very good scene. It's still quite cool, but I think we can do better than this. But I'm just going to take a photo of it anyway. Squirrel. Alrighty, so I've just walked around to another side of the woods, and we're hopefully going to find some other compositions here, and I know of one which was going to be really nice in this type of light, but yeah, let's go. Okay, so I found a pretty cool composition here. It's just of the light coming through the trees over there, and it's just got the aspects of the vanishing point and everything getting smaller and smaller and smaller the further away it is. And yeah, let's grab a look at this. I always like to have it on live view, so you can see exactly what you're focused on, and this is the picture I have at the moment. So yeah, that's the photo we're going to be taking. So the trees that I've been photographing here are called poplars. So these trees up there, that's the poplar there, poplar, poplar, poplar. I think they're all called poplars. There may be a more scientific name for them. But yeah, it's really cool to photograph them since they are bird of prey. It's the common buzzard, I think. He's just over there, looking for some mice or something to eat. But they're really fun to photograph because they're all lined up perfectly, so they're all straight. And the image that I've just been taking, all of the poplars were completely straight and in a line. They'll all be at the end like usual, but yeah. So this here is a shot that I've been wanting for a while. It's of the gate. Right, it doesn't want to focus. Anyway, there's a gate down there which I've been wanting to take a photo of, and it's incorporating some of the autumn colours into it. So you can see up there. Ah, focusing. Up there you can see some of the colours coming through up there, and it's got just the vanishing point again going all the way down towards that small little gate down there. Another thing that's really cool to do just to make everything look a lot more autumnal is to put one of these, just a leaf, in front of your lens, just in a tiny little corner of it or something. So if you have a look here, if I do it here, say that's the photo there. I just whack that at the top there, and it just makes everything at that top corner go just a little bit greener. And you can see it gone, just there now, gone there now. So you just incorporate a bit more autumn colour into your photos, which always makes it look a lot nicer. So I switched to my wide angle lens to get this shot. It's just with the trees running all the way down there. And it's got an awesome light on at the moment. And yeah. Okay guys, so at the moment I'm taking some video of the deer. And no, not of the deer. I wish of the deer, but actually I'm taking some video of the crows, pigeons and doves. And they're just so... they get scared so easy, so this is really intense, so I'm not going to be able to film any of it on this camera, but I'll definitely film it on this camera. So let's go do that. Alrighty guys, so I've just got some footage of the crows, and they're really, really cool. They were fighting each other. Unfortunately I didn't get that on camera, but I think it's time to head back now. And yeah. So guys, I've just been editing the video, and then I went to go and look for all of the pictures that I took on this trip, and unfortunately they all got deleted, but I have some on my phone, but I can't
work out how to upload them to the computer where I'm editing. So they're on my Instagram at the moment, and I am going to not put them in the video because I don't have the files for them. It's a real big shame, but yeah, it happens sometimes. But as you saw, I did get some quite cool composures. Anyway, I did get some quite cool scenes on my photography trip. Yeah, it was quite successful. Thank you for watching. Like and subscribe if you enjoyed. As always, till next time.